So now Jerome Adams is an Uncle Tom. This video is brought to you by The Officer Tatum Store. The Officer Tatum Store. Get the merch link in the description section. Make sure you like and subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell so you get notifications anytime I go live and make a video. Like this video. Share this video. Comment on this video. Let's get into this. Now, Jerome Adams, a brother with exuberance and intelligence, articulate, grew up in adversity, made something of himself, became the Surgeon General of the United States of America. The brother's resume is off the chain. And now he's an Uncle Tom because he decided to use vernacular that he grew up using, but because he's a black person that works for or works with the Republican Party, because he's articulate, because he made some of himself, somehow he's an Uncle Tom. I swear God is my witness. My blood pressure is running high at the ignorance from racist white liberals and these brain dead, chucking and jiving black fake activist lunatics that sit there and shame black folks whom they don't agree with and whom they feel don't have the juice or ain't a part of the culture. Y'all, I wasn't even gonna make no video. I was gonna let it go. But my boy ABL, Anthony Brian Logan, y'all should go check him out. I was looking on his page and I saw this video. Let me show y'all what Jerome Adams said. Let me say Dr. Jerome Adams. Let's get that correct. Let me show you what he said that has now got his name in this video trending on Twitter with the words Uncle Tom. Roll the film.
Stay at home if possible. If you must go out, maintain 6 feet of distance between you and everyone else, and wear a mask if you're going to be within 6 feet of others. Wash your hands more often than you ever dreamed possible. Avoid alcohol, tobacco, and drugs. And call your friends and family. Check in on your mother. She wants to hear from you right now. And speaking of mothers, we need you to do this, if not for yourself, then for your abuela. Do it for your granddaddy. Do it for your big mama. Do it for your pop-pop. We need you to understand, especially in communities of color, we need you to step up and help stop the spread so that we can protect those who are most vulnerable.
Now, y'all heard what the brother said. Comment, tell me, do you think that was anything wrong with him bringing up terms that he used within his family? You think it's weird him bringing up Big Mama? And they swear before God that the Republicans and people are not relatable, and then you relate to them, and then they call you an Uncle Tom. Now, you heard what he said. The world heard what he said. Most people with a connected brainstem realized that wasn't a big deal, and that, of course, he's not racist, and of course, he's not a sellout and Uncle Tom. But let me show you why. Listen to the question and listen to his response, destroying this ignorant reporter. Roll the film.
You said that African Americans and Latinos should avoid alcohol, drugs, and tobacco. You also said do it for your abuela, do it for Big Mama and Pop Pop. There are some people there are some people online that are already offended by that language and the idea that you're saying behaviors might be leading to these high death rates. Could you talk about whether or not people, could you, I guess, have a response for people who might be offended by the language that you used?
Well, I use that language because that's the language. I've been meeting with the NAACP, with the National Medical Association, with others. I actually talked with Derek Johnson multiple times this week, the head of the NAACP, and we need targeted outreach to the African-American community, and I use the language that is used in my family. I have a Puerto Rican brother-in-law. I call my granddaddy, granddaddy. I have relatives who call their grandparents Big Mama. So that was not meant to be offensive. That's the language that we use and that I use, and we need to continue to target our outreach to those communities. It is critically important that they understand it's not just about them. And I was very clear about that. It's not just about what you do, but you also are not helpless. We need to do our part at the federal level. We need people to do their parts at the state level, and we need everyone. black, brown, white, whatever color you are, to follow the president's guidelines, the coronavirus guidelines.
Before I start blasting, because I'm about to go off, I want to play one more video from Jerome, Dr. Jerome Adams. Play one more video so you can put this into context. This is not something that Dr. Jerome Adams just said randomly today. This is something that he's been preaching, he's been coordinating for a very long time. Watch this.
Look at being black in America. Number one, people unfortunately are more likely to be of low socioeconomic status, which makes it harder to social distance. Number two, we know that blacks are more likely to have diabetes, heart disease, lung disease, and I've shared myself personally that I have high blood pressure, that I have heart disease and spent a week in the ICU due to a heart condition, that I actually have asthma and I'm pre-diabetic. And so I represent that legacy of growing up poor and black in America, and I and many black Americans are at higher risk for COVID. It's why we need everyone to do their part to slow the spread.
Now the brother's resume is off the chain. What he said is backed up by evidence of his eagerness and zealousness to help the black folks when they claim nobody want to help them. Democrats sure ain't doing nothing. But now that all that has been said, what do y'all want? That they didn't have a problem with Hillary Clinton and her hot sauce, Pete Buttigieg faking like he's drinking a 40 ounce. They don't have a problem with Joe Biden talking about black kids and roaches. That's cool. It's cool, though. It's cool, though. It's cool, though. But a brother say something and they losing their mind. What do you want from him? What do you want from the American people? Everything gotta be racist. Everything gotta be about race. The brother can't spit facts to save his life without y'all acting a fool. Black people understand this. People in my family, as we speak, lung disease. My great-grandmother died from diabetes. We got cancer. All of these other things that run in our family. One of my family members just had surgery on the heart. I had to go into the urgent care the other day because I had some irregular heartbeats. Why do we got to get fake? Why do we got to get fake? We know what it is. But when the brother say it and he don't match the description that you want to see, he don't match the political party you want to see, you cannot receive it. It's crazy to me, ladies and gentlemen. It's crazy to me. Instead of, and I say this till I'm green in the face, instead of taking what the brother said and looking at this as if it's a crisis specifically for a group of people whom they claim Trump haven't addressed, although the Surgeon General, a black man, has addressed it numerous occasions. Because at first, they said, you can't get the COVID if you black. Remember that was circling around the black community? Oh, you can't. Oh, the black people can't get COVID. And now you're seeing them struggling more than any other race. And we already know the recipe for disaster, which we've been saying, which Republicans been talking about, but the liberals keep perpetuating. And now we see the fallout. But I could not believe my eyes and ears when I saw this video and heard from my boy ABL that people are losing their mind and calling this man a racist, calling this man an Uncle Tom. It's crazy to me, man. It's this slave mentality, this slave perpetuation psychologically, from slavery to now, perpetuated by a group of people in this country. It's blowing my mind. Black folks in today's world, we're on autopilot. Not me. I didn't walk off the plantation. We're on autopilot. Have you ever thought about this for a minute? Black people don't need the slave master to directly tell them, hurt other black people, despise other black people, hate each other. Don't build in your community. Don't build economic growth for generations. They don't have to tell you. They don't have to stop you. You're doing it to yourself. Every time a brother make it to the top, they shun him. I had a young lady reach out to my wife, and she said she wanted to write a report about a black activist whom she think has made an impact in the black community. She wanted to choose me, right? She thought that I've made a tremendous impact in the black community. She know my wife. She see what I do. She brought me to her teacher, whom I'm assuming is a black man. and she's in an Africana studies class, and the person said, I'm not eligible. B. Tatum can't be eligible because I don't fit the spectrum in which they want me to, because I'm not sitting here claiming that the Democratic Party has done great things when they have done nothing. I'm not sitting here bashing President Trump when I know the man has done a good job, whether I like the way he do business or not. Because B. Tatum ain't an SJW, and I'm not walking around blaming the white man for anything that has happened in my life that has been negative. Because I'm not sitting around bumping, rubbing elbows with people who do not have integrity, people who would not stand up for what's right and what's wrong, people who hate the police department for no reason, people who hate white people, who hate this country. Because B. Tatum ain't standing for that, I cannot be an effective activist in the black community. Let me inform you, like Mr. Dr. Jerome Adams, I grew up in a black neighborhood. I graduated from Paul Lawrence Dunbar High School. Some of y'all don't even know Paul Lawrence Dunbar is a famous black poet, which is the school is named after him. My whole life, I've been around black folks. My whole family is black. I've seen the ins and outs. When I was in college, I took Africana studies. On the police department, I was one of the only black police officers. And while I was there, I represented my department at the National Black Association, the National Black Police Conference, on numerous occasions. I not only speak into a community of people who are ready to wake up who happen to be black, I led one of the biggest movements that has ever gone to the White House of black conservatives with Turning Point USA. I'm co-founder of a black organization called Blexit. I could go on and on the impact that I have in the black community. The problem is that they don't want to accept people like me. They don't want to accept people like Dr. Jerome Adams. They don't want to accept people like Ben Carson. They don't want to accept people like Thomas Sowell, Larry Elder. I can go down a list. Dabani. Do I need to keep going? Derek, David Harris Jr. I can keep going. They don't want to accept us because we're not putting ourselves in a position to be victims. Now, I'm going to save all this for another video. But I want to know what you think about Jerome Adams. What do y'all think of Dr. Jerome Adams? What do y'all think about what was said? Why in the heck is he trending on Twitter? People calling him an Uncle Tom. Let me know right in the comment section. Like, subscribe to the channel. Visit the Officer Tatum store. We get all the cool merch. Y'all know what it is. I'll see you on the next one. I'm out.